Hello, Truth Seekers. Dennis Nappy II here with Sixth Sense Media and the Seeker Podcast, bringing you another special report as we continue to move through this coronavirus, COVID-19 quarantine, shelter in place, running out of resources, scary, fear it up scenario. Today's Tuesday, March 17th. It's 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I got to tell you, man, my buddy, a friend of mine, keeps sending me information, and every time he sends it, it's a joke, like a literal joke with a punchline. And I look at it at the most inappropriate times. A tough lesson to be learned. I was just on the air with the crypto team, and he sends me what looks like a video of people standing in line, and I'm like, oh, maybe I'm getting some irrelevant update from a friend of mine who's out there in the field. And I click on it, looking at this line, and it instantly shifts to someone's rear end breaking wind, and then Dave Chappelle going, gotcha, bitch! And I'm in the middle of it. I never should have checked my phone, but I was in the middle of a debrief with the team, and I couldn't, I started laughing. So don't check messages from your friends, no matter how relevant you think they may be. He got me. That's the second time my friend has got me with stuff like that, so I owe him. I'm sharing that because, look, you have to find a way to laugh at times during this. There are some very serious things going on, but we need to find ways to cope with stress management. I want to talk real quick tonight. I'm going to keep it short. Plans for the future. What are we looking at beyond the virus? As I've been saying, as the crypto team has been putting out, the economy is going through a transition. I don't think it's going to happen overnight. I do see from the research we've been doing over at Crypto Viewing for a while now that the infrastructure is there, the foundation is laid. I've talked to a lot of people who are still very skeptical and opinionated about cryptocurrency, and that's okay. I have my own opinions about cryptocurrency and about a new economy and everything that's going on. But I think we need to take our opinions out of this, and we need to look at the facts. We need to look at the evidence. I challenge you, start researching not just cryptocurrency and is it viable and what is this expert's opinion of it. I want you to look at, pick a company a day, a company a week, whatever, and spend a half hour looking at the company, look at the people in charge, look at who they're connected to. Now, an easy way to do that, if you subscribe to our Patreon at Crypto Viewing, it's not a shameless plug. This is what we've been doing for the past year plus in looking at this, and you'll see what this infrastructure is and how this is actually rolling out. But I got some news that's easy to share today that came across. I think Ray sent me one or two of these articles that I'm going to share real quick with all of you. And this first one here, it's dated Monday, March 16th, 2020. Here's the headline. This is from the papers, PAYPERS. Bank of England considers introduction of, here it is, digital currency. Bank of England has issued a discussion paper considering the introduction of a digital currency in the UK for use by businesses and customers. This would be an electronic form of central bank money that could be used by households and businesses to make payments alongside cash and money held in bank accounts. The new form of money would not replace paper banknotes and physical cash, but would run alongside it. Yes, it will not replace it yet, but we're looking at a transition now, and here it comes. That's evidence number one. This also dated March 16th, 2020, from the Daily HODL. U.S. Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin appoints Coinbase Chief Legal Officer to oversee banking system. Now, if you're not familiar with cryptocurrency, Coinbase is a very big exchange. It's where you go to buy or exchange cryptocurrency. The person who just got appointed to oversee the U.S. banking system was the chief legal officer. The chief legal officer of Coinbase. Think about that. That is huge. They're getting a cryptocurrency expert to now oversee U.S. banking. I don't know what else to say about that. It's coming. The change is coming. And again, hands down, crypto viewing is the best place to get that information. But start doing your own research. You need to learn how to get cryptocurrency, how to store cryptocurrency, how to secure cryptocurrency and protect your assets. There's a lot to learn there. And there's a lot of videos out there. There's a lot of discussions that are out there on telling you what to do and how to do it. Some pretty easy do-it-yourself videos. I don't want to say pretty easy. You're going to spend some time. But if you're home right now, you have time. And I think you should really take a look. And I'm not a financial advisor. So I'm not giving you financial advice, but if it were me, I would look at my finances, look at the economy, and do an assessment and make a decision on what it is that you think you should do. I'm going to cover this more in greater detail on an upcoming podcast, but this is big news. I think this is big news. This is what we call an indicator or indicators and warnings that a shift is coming. I don't have a timeline. I don't think you're going to wake up tomorrow and it's going to be, boom, here's cryptocurrency. My opinion, I think there's going to be somewhat of a gradual transition, I hope. But in the meantime, we're still seeing people losing a lot of money as these markets fall, and then they're pumping them back up, and then they're falling, and now they're talking about an economic stimulus. I mean, how far is $1,000 going to carry you, really? Hoping it holds this economy up, but my opinion, I think we're on a downward spiral, which is a precursor to the new upswing. Question is, where will you fall during a transition like that? Speaking of transitions, again, with this hardship, we haven't even begun to think about the impacts that are coming from this change that we're going through right now. The economic impact, the psychological impact, and beyond with resources. Supply chains have already been disrupted. A lot of companies are going out of business. We saw how the riots, not riots, but the panic shopping hit the grocery stores. Now with everything being shut down, are people afraid to go out? Will they be afraid to go out as the death toll rises? We're going to see those numbers go up. We're going to see the media scare them up. That has an impact on society in a way that we can move society and herd society in directions of thought and action. And I'm not saying that to encourage you to go against what you're being told. I'm saying it so you can safeguard your own psychological well-being as you see and hear these things coming. What is the future going to look like, the near future? We may see food rationed out. We may see distributions, authorized distribution centers set up that may have the National Guard or Armed Guard or police officers, some kind of restricted access. We may then have to create some kind of list to verify who we are. What a great opportunity to get your digital ID. So these are things that I think we should mentally prepare for. What if we have an authority telling us what we can and can't purchase at this point? Amazon is restricting what you can buy right now or what can be shipped. So liberty has been incredibly restricted right now in the name of this crisis. How are you handling that? And I worry, if you don't have enough of what you need, what are you going to do about it? My hope is that you're taking this time to inventory the things that you have. What's on hand in your own home, in your own supply, that you can use to stretch things, that you can use to create things, that you can use to barter and trade if that becomes safe and authorized. Are you gardening? Are you saving food scraps? Are you looking up recipes on ways to stretch the food that you do have? Now you have the time. Get creative. If you're living in a city, obviously you can't go out and go foraging for food. What's your plan? It may seem hopeless, but right now time is on your side. Start doing some reading and some research and deciding how you're going to get through this. And come up with contingencies, come up with plans where if this option, and think of every possible scenario you can, not everyone, but think of a lot of scenarios. If I have to leave, what's that going to look like? What will I need? Where will I go? If I have to leave, what's that going to look like? What will I do? Where will I go? How will I go? Who will I tell? Who will I go with? What do I need to have with me on my person that's absolutely essential that I have it? These are all things I think we should be thinking about right now in this time. I know we're all obsessed with social distancing and now we're stuck in our house and the bar's closed and... But let's start thinking beyond that as well. I mean, let it not consume your whole day, because a lot of us have families that we're worrying about, and fill your day with positive memories, as I spoke about yesterday, with those opportunities that you want to take to make memories, make the most of the situation that you're in. Enjoy the time that you have with your loved ones. All right, friends, I'm keeping it short tonight. Let me know your thoughts. Comment below or send me an email, sixcentsmedia.net. Let me know what you're thinking on this. And because I know cryptocurrency, it's a heated argument right now. But I see this shift coming. I think that's where we're going. I'm going to end it here. It's getting late for me. Have a wonderful evening. And hopefully we can connect again tomorrow. I'm Dennis Nappy II with Sixth Sense Media and host of The Secret Podcast, where small changes among the masses can have a massive impact around the world. I encourage you to be that change. Never stop questioning. Keep an open mind and let your intuition be your guide. Thanks for listening.